reports on the plane. Anything new?
Conclusive evidence through vapor trace analysis that it was a bomb. RDX residue, probably Semtex. Other than that, nothing.
What agencies are involved?
Name it. The Bureau, ATF, DC Metro. No egos. People just want to get it done. Jack Pearson's heading the task force.
At 12:20 a.m., Washington Post received the first call claiming responsibility. It was made from a pay phone at 28th and Lincoln, West District. Forensics is examining the booth for prints.
Take heed, agents of Zog. Tonight's hellfire is only the beginning. Our capital's been designated a kill zone, as prophesized in the Turner Diaries. The Covenant of Zog will be overthrown. True Americans have renounced this bastard son of freedom and justice. Repent. Abolish the IRS. The people will prevail.
We're in the process of going through the NSTL. Agent Mills.
No intelligence reports of increased militia activity.
An English pub is an unlikely target.
This next call is scarier. Received 23 minutes after the incident.
Tonight, at 10 after midnight, the ANO claims 13 lives as payment for the continuing oppression of our people. Withdraw your support for the Zionists.
ANO, Abu Nidal Organization. Maybe the Fatah Revolutionary Council feels left out of the peace talks.
There's a time discrepancy.
For the media, we established the time of the blast at 10 minutes after midnight. In actuality, detonation was dead on at 12. This next call received 10 minutes prior. It's a code similar to IRA bomb alerts used in England. Those tones correspond to the numbers 522-666.
Queen's Arms is a hangout for British Embassy employees. State Department's given us a background on the victims.